Hi again. In this video, we're going to continue with our if-then or conditional statements, and we're going to look at some different combinations. So for example, does it work to reverse an if-then statement? And maybe you've had this happen to you, or you made some conditional statement and someone flipped it around. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so our original conditional statement, we're going to use letters so that we can talk about these different combinations. So if A, I'm actually going to put that in green, and then B, I'm going to put in purple. Okay, so if A, then B, that's what we've been talking about. That's our original conditional statement. Now, there's a name for these other combinations. So the converse is when you switch it around. So if you say if B, so now the purple's first, then A. So that's the reverse. Notice it's not like just switching the order of the if then. It's the actual, the if is now B and the then is now A, okay? So they've actually changed the meaning of the statement. Okay, so then the inverse is when you put a not in both of them. So you keep the original if and the original then, but you have a not in there. So if not A, then not B. And then the contrapositive is the flipping around. It's really the converse of the inverse, but we won't, don't worry about that. If not B, so now we're putting B first, but if not B, then not A. Okay, so let's try an example so we can see what's going on with this. I've got the four statements here. The original, the converse, the inverse, and contrapositive, and we're going to look at which ones are equivalent to each other, okay? So the original, and I'm going to try to keep my original color coding as best I can. So the original is if you are not late, okay? So that's our A. If you are not late, then you get coffee. So that's our B. And I'll put the if as well. If A, then B. Okay, so that means if you're not late, then you get coffee, okay? The converse to that is if you get coffee, then you're not late. So now we're saying if B, then A. Okay, and then let's say our original is true, that if you are not late, then you do get coffee, okay? If you get coffee, does that mean you weren't late? Not necessarily, right? Because maybe you had a different way to get coffee. Maybe you brought it with you. You could have been late, but you showed up with coffee. So this doesn't necessarily have the same meaning as this one. Okay. Now let's look at the inverse. So if you are late, so the inverse is if not A. So I'm back to green. If not, but it's the opposite. So if you are late, because the first one original was not. So if you are late, then you don't get coffee. Then you don't get coffee. So this is then, not B. If you are late, then you don't get coffee. Okay, so if you are late, if you're not late, you do get coffee. If you are late, you don't get coffee. Well, let's say you are late. Again, maybe you brought your coffee with you. So these two are actually equivalent to each other. The converse and the inverse have the same meaning as each other, and same truth value. Okay, let's look at the contrapositive. If you don't get coffee, then you are late. Okay, so let's remember, if you are not late, that's A. Okay, and so this is then you are late. So this is then not A. And this is if you don't get coffee, coffee was B. So this is if not B. So let's just double check that this checks out as the contrapositive. If not B, then not A. Okay, if you don't get coffee, then you are late. Okay, so if this original was true, as long as you're not late, you get coffee. Then if you didn't get coffee, you were late. Okay, so these two are equivalent. The original and the contrapositive, those are equivalents. Equivalent to each other. Okay, and then I summarize this down here. Logical equivalence. The original statement and its contrapositive, the original and the contrapositive are logically equivalent, meaning if one's true, the other's true. If one's false, the other's false. The converse and the inverse are logically equivalent, meaning if one's true, the other's true. If one's false, the other's false. Okay, so I hope you have a good time practicing that in your homework, and I'll see you in the next video.